story about slug slime and how it's inspiring better biomedical adhesives.
One of my favorite stories of 2017 was the March for Science.
Yeah, so for me, my favorite story had to be the collision of two neutron stars that was detected gravitational waves and light at the same time. It was so much fun reporting that story because there were, like, every scientist that I talked to about it was just so excited. They were all totally losing their minds over this discovery.
So I love this one section of the magazine called 50 Years Ago, where we go back and we look in our back archives. I think it was the September 28th issue of 1967. We wrote about catching commercial airliners in nets when they landed, which I just love.
The detection of this previously unknown void inside the Great Pyramid at Giza. They discovered this void using muon detectors to pick up these particles called muons that are created in the upper atmosphere when cosmic rays smash into atmospheric particles. It was this sort of crazy, beautiful juxtaposition of this super high-tech technology that we have now in terms of the muon detectors and, you know, this really ancient technology of pyramid design and building.
One of my favorites was definitely Supernova 1987A. I got to do a video that combined claymation and glitter, which are like my two favorite things.
How kids in a farming community in Africa do the marshmallow test much more effectively than kids in Western countries do.
Yeah, I really liked that story. I thought it really highlighted for me just how much of what we consider often to be these kind of like very basic psychological principles are actually heavily influenced by the culture that we live in, even when you're dealing with like a four-year-old child.
My favorite story for the year was your explanation of how hybrids can happen.
Susan, that's
wonderful. I mean, it's something that people should know. It's a really basic thing that schools don't teach people.
Well, that's funny because my favorite story of the year is your essay on what a species is.
The discovery of the 7 Earth-sized planets in the TRAPPIST system that Ashley Yeager and Lisa Grossman wrote about for obvious SETI fangirl reasons, where there's all of this potential real estate out there for aliens to be living on.
I like stories where the public and science come together, and this year we dug into some provocative issues like about gun statistics, whether with the CRISPR technology, whether like as it goes along, are we going to be obligated to CRISPR our kids?
I really loved working on the vampire story. Mm-hmm. It was like pretty crazy to learn about all the different animals that are technically vampires. Kind of blew my mind. And it's just really fun and really creepy.
I really like the story that Laurel Hamers wrote on scallop eyes, which like, first of all, I didn't even know that scallops had eyes, so that's cool to begin with. But then the eyes are like really intricate and really amazing. It's like all these tiny little rectangular, almost like mirrors that reflect the light and focus it like a telescope.
I think I'm actually going to go with the death of Cassini. It was such a very high stakes and very emotional, dramatic moment, and I don't know, I was really into it.
Well, Cassini was pretty emotional, but I gotta say the Eclipse was also up there.
Who didn't get excited about the Eclipse? That was, of course, one of our...
The Eclipse was mind-blowing.
Loved the Eclipse.
I know, the Eclipse was awesome.
We all got our glasses and went outside and looked up. It was pretty awesome. I was with Susan Milius, and she was having the best time ever.
I just loved walking around looking at how the shadows changed.
I mean, I feel like everyone was having the best time ever during an eclipse.
It's just going to be a compilation of people going eclipse, eclipse, eclipse.
Part of my job is trolling through a lot of the comments on our site and just like, you know, making sure like everything's in order and all that. And there are some regulars I've come to recognize at this point. And there was a point a couple months into my job when I realized they were mentioning me by name. So thanks, thanks Doug, for calling me out in the comment section. Yes, I do read pretty much everyone.
I had an experience. I was at Dragon Con, which is a big pop culture extravaganza where everyone dresses up like their favorite sci-fi character.
What were you wearing?
At that point, I think I was dressed as Princess Leia.
Ah.
I was approached by this girl who was dressed as a student at Hogwarts, and she told me that she was really excited to meet me because she recognized my name from two stories that I had written about CRISPR, because she had written a report in her high school about using CRISPR, and she had used my stories as references.
Oh, I had a guy from the Netherlands email me in Dutch to tell me about how he had an egg explode in his mouth after I wrote about exploding eggs. I really appreciated that reader feedback.
I feel like 2017 it's ended with some nice big discoveries.
Lots of gravitational waves.
So 2017, CRISPR.
Yeah.
Which was also 2016, but yeah, 2017 was CRISPR again.
I wrote about AI doing everything this year, from predictive policing to driving cars to sorting resumes, to discovering new exoplanets and new types of dolphin clicks. And I think AI is really sort of touching everything these days in science and society. And I'm excited to see how people continue to grapple with that in 2018.
Let's meet here next year. Same place, same planet.
So we usually catch planes on aircraft carriers by hooking their butts with giant hooks that are actually wires stretched across the deck.
I saw this in the movie Airplane.